need you to write to Congress, I need you to write to the president and tell them local governments need help.
The county executive, not mincing words, your local government needs your help. Good evening, everyone. I'm Jeff Russo. The total number of COVID cases are holding steady in Erie County, but the costs associated with the pandemic continue to rise. And that's why the county executive is now asking you to step up and take action. Hannah Bueller reports.
Erie County Executive Mark Polenkar says the county is doing well in the fight against COVID-19, but at least for the foreseeable future, things will not be going back to the way they were before the pandemic. Masks and social distancing are here to stay. That is the new normal to keep numbers low. At this point, more than 20,000 people have been tested in the county, and the infection rate is less than 1%. Still, county officials are cracking down on bars and restaurants and investigating any and all complaints. There have been 84 public complaints in the first 5 days of August. Erie County officials have looked into 2,000 complaints since restaurants reopened. As we told you yesterday, Republican members of the Erie County Legislature are putting forth the Business Closure Reporting Act, which would require any Erie County employee responsible for shutting down a restaurant to provide reasoning to the legislature. Polenkar has responded to that request.
Already on the Healthy Space website, that's the information. All bars are provided the justification for their shutdown, all restaurants. So they know why they were shut down. They get the documents. So for them to say that they don't know why they were shut down is false, because they get the documents that identify why they were shut down.
As for Major League Baseball players from other states coming to Buffalo, Health Commissioner Dr. Gail Burstein says players will come directly from the airport to their hotels. No players from the MLB and other states will be out and about in Western New York. Polenkar also said he is working with the state to reopen bowling alleys, which have been shut down since mid-March. Reporting in Buffalo, Hannah Bueller, 7 Eyewitness News.